This video will go over the next steps in connecting your FeedbackWhiz account. You should have already received your email to verify your account. Once you've received that email, you'll be directed into Account Settings to Marketplace. And in here, you'll be able to connect your appropriate marketplace. Make sure it is the appropriate one by clicking on one of these. Once you click on it, then click Connect Amazon Seller Account. And you'll be navigated into this page. Once you're here, go ahead and click on step one. Once you click on step one, you'll be directed into this page, which is your Amazon Marketplace web services, and the developer's name and ID is already pre-filled for you. Once you're here, just go ahead and click next. Once you click next, you'll be navigated into this page. Just read all of this first, and once you confirm, go ahead and check this box and click next. You'll be directed into this page where FeedbackWhiz can now access your Amazon seller account with MWS. So from right here in this area, you would just need to copy over your seller ID, this section, and then your MWS auth token. Once you have them copied, go ahead and go back into FeedbackWhiz and paste it into seller ID section right here for the seller ID, and then paste in the MWS auth token right here. Once you have those pasted in, this is where you would input your Amazon seller email address. All the emails you send from FeedbackWhiz have to be routed through Amazon Seller Central before it reaches your customer. Please make sure you check that you have inputted the correct email address, otherwise no emails can pass through to your customers. If you want to use a different email address, make sure that this email address is an approved email inside Seller Central. You can click on this link here to add your email address inside Seller Central. So once the email is done, on step five, you can select how many past days of order history you want to fetch by clicking this dropdown. The benefits of selecting more history is so you can either email past orders, or we can get more data such as repeat buyers or feedback history to improve your campaign targeting. However, if you have a large amount of past orders, such as over 10,000, the sync process can take several hours. Once you have this all filled out, go ahead and click connect. Once you've connected, you'll be able to see that the marketplace is syncing right here. This is the status, and this will refresh every time you go into this page, with the oldest order being right here, depending on how far back you selected your order data to go. While you wait for the sync for your marketplaces, you can scroll down here and see the Seller Central integration and Seller Central notifications. For the SCI, the purpose of this is so we can monitor your positive seller feedback. You would just click Connect Seller Central. And if you needed more detailed instructions, just click this icon that will take you into support.feedbackwhiz.com. For Seller Central notifications, SCN, this is so FeedbackWhiz would be a notification recipient in your Amazon Seller Central, so we can monitor your buyers who have opted out of Amazon third-party emails, and we can monitor your order refund statuses. This will be in real time, so there's this article right here for a guide on how to set this up. Once that is all set up, you can go ahead and create your templates by going to this drop-down menu to Template Manager, and once you click on that, you'll be navigated into this page, and we do provide pre-built templates for you, but if you wanted to create a new email template, just click this. And once you're on this email template page, you would just create a template name for this email, the email subject line, and then this is where you'll be typing in this box, and this is where you'll be able to see the live preview of how your email will look like. Once you have this all filled out, just click save, and there's videos that go over how to build customizable templates. So once you have this saved, once you click save into your template, it will navigate you back into the template manager. So then go ahead and go into campaigns to campaign manager. Once you're inside your campaigns, you would just click create new email campaign, and this is what will automate your email process. You would just create a name for your campaign right here, and then this is where you would select your email template. Once you have that selected, you would just fill out your target order, schedule, order matching rules, all of this, and click save right here, review and save. And there's videos going over how to create your campaigns as well. So once you click review and save, once that's complete, underneath products, you can go into the product monitoring page right here, and this is where you would monitor your products for product reviews. And you would just select which ASINs you want to monitor by easily just clicking on these boxes and clicking add. Make sure you always save it, and then this is going to be your monitored list on this side. Once you have these products monitored on this side, you can go ahead and go into the product manager page right here. Once you're inside your product manager page, you'll be able to see the ASINs that you're monitoring easily on this page. And then this is where your set listing alerts are. And we allow hijacker listing alerts, buy box notifications, and item title notifications. You can easily click enable on these, and you can also do a bulk edit as well. Once you have these enabled, they turn a darker gray color. That means that these listing alerts are turned on. When they're actually a lighter gray color, that means they are not turned on yet. Once you have your listing alerts set on, then you can go ahead and go underneath products to product review manager. All of the ASINs that you selected to monitor will show the product reviews on this page. It does take up to 6 hours to complete that sync, so this page will show all of your product reviews easily, and you'll be able to group them by most recent right here, or you can group them by product and easily just read all of the reviews for these ASINs. To understand more of the functionality of these features that I went over, you can refer to support.feedbackwhiz.com, and they have more in-depth articles of all of these features. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and for more information, please visit feedbackwhiz.com.